as Scorpio. I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love lives or your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Scorpions, it's a big, big month. We have Uranus, the planet of unpredictability, chaos. He's pretty much the wild boy of astrology. And he changes sign this month. He's moving from Aries, where it has been there for the last 7 years. And now it moves to Taurus, where it is going to be there for the next 7 years. Now, Uranus is also known as the planet of rebellion. And despite all the humanitarian qualities that it stands up for, and in fact, even there's a lot of inspiration that comes with the Uranian qualities, but if Uranus is aspected badly in your chart, it can make you prone to more risk taking, which could put you in danger, and it may not be really good for your well-being. It also increases your gambling instincts. It makes you really impetuous, and also there is this entire sense of wanting freedom at any cost. So depending on which part of your chart Uranus is aspecting, that is a part which requires a lot of transformation, because Uranus brings about chaos, upheaval, and along with it comes change, which is extremely important in order for transformation to take place. And Uranus, for these 7 years, it's going to be showing the need to, as a society, I think, need to look at things which no longer work for us. It's going to be a fight against conformity. So if there have been atrocities that have, you may have earlier turned your head away from, whether they are on children or on animals or on people who really can't speak for themselves, this is a time to be more involved. It's not the time to be turning your head and being a armchair participant or hiding behind your laptops and, you know, voicing your disdain or your horror. But this is a time to be physically, be participative in something that you really feel strongly about, and also something which should not be done on a humane level. So this entire Uranian circle is going to be bringing about a lot of conflict. It's going to be bringing about what is truly really right, what is it that really works for you. And for you, it's going to be, there's a lot of focus on love, romance, creativity, children, and Uranus will bring about a lot of opportunities for you to look at these areas in your life and really understand for yourself what is it that you really need, what is it that really goes beyond working. Does it really touch you at a soul level? Is it something that is there for good? It could be a bumpy ride. You may feel that, you know, if you have been specially been hankering after a certain stability or an I would say even a predicted future, that's something that you could be seeking. But Uranus will ask you to be flexible. It will ask you to explore, look beyond what is it that can't be seen from the naked eye. And it's, I think, to really work with the Uranian energy, you really need to be true to yourself, really to the, you know, bring it back down to the bare bones. What is it that really affects you? What is it that really, really matters to you? It has to be beyond a nice house and earning an X salary. It has to be more than what is the value that you really bring, not just to yourself, but to the world at large. It's really, really a large picture. And it's also a time to be making choices, some very hard choices for yourself, and there are really no right or any wrong or choices. But when you have clarity, it's always easier to make that decision. Now, for the first few weeks, Pluto and Mars, they're conjuncting in your house of communication. It's a powerful time to be connecting with some very powerful, well-connected people. And this has to do with your contract. This has to do with your job negotiations. On the 14th, we have a Mercury, and thankfully it's direct. And it's joining Sun, and it's moving into your house of relationships, both work as well as personal relationships. A lot of communication, conversations that are going on. On the 15th, we have a new moon that is there in your house of relationships. And this is a time that you'll find an opportunity maybe for a new partnership. You may find yourself in a new relationship, or maybe the relationship takes a new turn. On the 16th, we have the drum roll. Uranus that is rolling into your house of relationships for the next 7 years. So this is an opportunity, really, Scorpios. Don't get faced by that, oh, unpredictable and it's not going to last. But it's really a time to be giving a breath of new life, fresh air, fresh perspective to your relationship. And how it is that, what is it rather that you seek from your relationship? Yes, peace is going to be very important. It's going to be very, very important that you not only will require space, but your partner also could demand space. And I think relationships in which you allow each other to breathe will really flower well. It's not really, and I would say irrespective of the Uranus transit, I think any relationship when you try and sort of suffocate it too much with expectations or with complaints, disdain, disappointments, there's no room for the relationship to really blossom or even flower for that matter. So with this entire Uranian energy for the next 7 years, it's a time for being flexible to changes. It's a time for exciting developments. It's a time for exciting developments in your relationships. It's a time to be looking and exploring areas of your relationships in a very unconventional way. Try sort of not to seek the well-walked path, Scorpios. Maybe there's a separation of sorts also which you have with your loved one. Maybe that separation will bring about a new insight, new depth to your relationship. You do not know. But you have to stay fluid and don't fear the Uranian energy, because it will bring about lasting impact along with it. On the 17th, we have Mars that moves into your house of house, home. This is a space which is ruled by Cancer. It rules your mother, and it's a great time. Some of you could be renovating, a wonderful time to be decluttering. Just let go of the stuff, the clothes that you don't need. Just donate it to a cause, or give it away to people who need them more than you. It will also give you more mind space. That is what actually physical decluttering does as well. On the 20th, we have Venus that moves into your house of expansion of the mind, spirituality and studying. Fantastic time for meeting people, networking, educating yourself. Pick up that course that you've been eyeing for the longest. Maybe it's in another country. Go and get yourself skilled. Just take that risk. It's a great time also to be teaching. It's a great time to be learning something new. Add a new skill. Learn from people from different cultures, societies, ethnicities. Absorb and imbibe that into your life as well. On the 21st, we have Sun that moves into your house of joint finances, resources, sexuality, and also transformation. So, time for insurances, taxes, finances. Get in touch with your CA. Do again a budgeting thing, a pro and a con exercise as far as your monies are concerned. And we are closing the month with a full moon. And this is there in your house of how it is that you value yourself, Scorpios, and the money that you earn. Very important. I think you can expect some financial changes. Something is coming to fruition for you. Maybe a project is closing for you. Maybe a job, you're in the process of changing your job. You're moving to another one. For some of you, it speaks about releasing the past and really embracing the new that is there at work, and all this of it is related as well with your self-esteem. Try not to measure yourself with how much you earn and what is it that you do with the amount of money that you're able to earn. Scorpios, it has very less to do with it, even though we most of the time connect the both, and that is how we look at people, that oh, that one is on, you know, he's a CEO of a company, so he must be a great person, so on and so forth. It is not so. You cannot define yourself by the amount of money that you make. It really means different for different people. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Scorpios. I'll see you again soon, and thank you so much for watching.